Hi, this is Dewey with RemoteFiringSystems.com. In this video, we'll talk about how to use the MS-32Q. So when you're receiving the MS-32Q, you see that this is the module. It has a power port on the side, key switch, comes with two keys, has a learn button so you can learn remotes. Has a toggle switch, middle off positions for the learn mode. There's a test function once you have igniters in the firing system itself. I have a little grain of wheat bulb in here right now. It shows continuity from one point to the other. See, as I move this little, it flickers a little bit. Should be bright green if it has continuity. No continuity or empty queue is both green and red. So if there's something in the queue, you should have a bright green light. It doesn't tell you 100% that igniter or igniters are going to ignite. If you have igniters in parallel, it only takes one good igniter to show continuity. And what parallel is more than two igniters. So you grab the leads from two or more igniters, one of each gets twisted together. Grab the other two that are left, twist them together. Then that gets put into the queue. That's a parallel connection. A series connection is when the first wire from the first igniter is in one queue and the last igniter from the last, or the last lead of the last igniter is in the other terminal for that queue. You do not put the clip igniters in series. Clip igniters are in parallel only. You can use MJG initiators and real ematch in series, but make sure they're from the same box. This is the antenna system. It is replaceable. I sell very few. So most people don't have an issue with them. So it should be used straight up in the air, extended all the way, and the firing system module itself should be at least 18 inches up off the ground plane so that the remote, or so that can it can receive the remote signal. We will just leave it down in the down position so I don't have to work around it. So that's the test function. I have videos about the remotes, but we will quickly just learn this manual remote, and we'll use the manual remote as far as how the firing system works. Probably already okay. So I learn mode, push learn until the green light came on, and if it hasn't learned this remote before, it will blink twice indicating that it's learned this remote. If this code was already in there, it would just turn off that green light, that is. So to use it, we put it in arm mode within A, B, C, and D banks. So in the manual, we would push A. This bank is chosen and go 1 through 8. Okay, so now A is done. We would choose another bank, A, B, or C, D. Okay, it's as simple as that. As far as, say you pushed a button, it will not allow you to push that button again for 5 seconds, allowing that MOSFET to cool down as part of the overload protection. These firing systems will put out up to 10 amps. So it's a good thing to have a battery that can actually do that. If you if you've ever watched my videos, you know I do not recommend using AA batteries. It will work. I definitely wouldn't recommend it with the clip igniters, and if you do put some energizers in here, I believe it's 6 AA's. There's a on-off switch on the side. This plugs right into the port, and only one clip igniter per Q, no more than that. You have to go through all 32 Qs, and you don't want to weaken the batteries halfway through and have them not start firing. I think the only time I've had a complaint about power is when somebody's been trying to use these and they just grab some AA batteries and put in it. So if you are going to use it, make sure you use quality batteries. We recommend an external power source. This is the one we sell, Interstate 12 volt 2.3 AH battery, and you can buy the charger for it if you need a charger. With this arrangement, this battery, 6 clip igniters per Q, 6 E-match or initiators in parallel per Q, or up to a dozen E-match in series. You can use a lot of batteries, your lawnmower battery, your deep cycle boat battery for your trolling motor, a 12 volt starter kit for starting vehicles would work. You can use 12 to 24 volts, so that's a wide range of voltage as far as batteries also. When placing a wire into the Q terminals, I just have a this is from the Renegade Slat, but they all work the same as far as the springs, and there's just little knobs that hold these clips in. One thing you do not ever do is push inward on these to try to tighten the connection. Just let the spring do its job. You will break them every time. I've had brand new systems used once and they come back with 4 broken because they just thought they needed to push in. These are tight connections. You can always wiggle them also. So wiggle them a little bit after installing. When installing singles or even doubles, double over the wire so there's double connection. Always double over the wire so that there's that loop of wire in there that's 2 wires instead of 1 for a better connection, and always have it so that the wire is close or not a lot of wire exposed, and that you spread that out so there's no way that can touch. We call that the Q killer. If copper wire is touching like this at a Q, it might not be that way when you started, but you got to get all through all 32 Qs. You're moving wires, they get pulled on. If there's a lot of exposed wires, I've been to some club shoots where people just starting out, you know, they don't clip the wires at all, and there's half an inch of copper sticking out. That's a bad scenario. You'll never see that at a 1-3 show with people that, you know, have done it for a long time. They very, very, very strict about making sure that nothing can touch so that Q is actually going to fire and you're not going to damage the firing system circuits. Again, like I say, if you push in on these, you can break them. So don't do that. We'll go through the use of the 6 button. Again, I have another video with this remote explaining how to use it with the system. On-off switch, make sure it's off when you're not using it. If it goes to sleep, it will just continue to use battery. Might not see this light on, but if it falls asleep and this is left on, you're going to have a dead battery when you go to use it again. When you turn it on, this light should be red. If not, push the stop button. The MS32Q does not work with the start, pause, or continue buttons. That's for the MB32Q. So if you were to hit start, this remote will not work with the MS32Q. in step. Start's been chosen. You know, I've had people ask me about that, and the remote will not work with my MS-32Q. Most likely the start function has been chosen. So when you start the remote up, oops, make sure that it's in red. Antenna extends, always use it straight up in the air. To learn the remote to this system, middle learn position, push learn button till the light comes on, push stepper, blink twice. If it was already in there, it would just go off. You'll learn one code from this remote, and learn from the code from this remote, and it'll work with either one of them. Once the step function has been started, it will not work with the manual remote. It is locked into the step function until pushing stop. Personally, this is the remote I like to use with the systems. I'm just manually shooting a show. It can't get any easier than this. You may want the manual remote also, you know, to have a second remote, or in testing the remote, you know, it comes with a little bulb like there, like this, so that you can test. It can be easier to use the manual remote as far as hitting A and then one to test each cue. When testing them, you can put them in test mode, take the bulb, keep moving it through, make sure all the button lights are working. But again, that's why that they're all on right now, is it is actually showing you that all bulbs are working, and in test function only the green is brighter when there's actually continuity. In fire mode, the only thing you're going to see is the red light come on, showing that that cue is active. If you ever see when turning on or the remote or the firing system, one of these red lights is on and stays on, that's an indication that that's a damaged cue. Put tape on that cue. Do not use it for that show. Return it to remotefiringsystems.com for and I can repair that cue if it has been damaged too bad. But the only time you're in, it shouldn't happen, but it can. The only time that's going to happen is if the wires are crossed right at the cue. The firing system is supposed to disable that cue because the continuity is zero or near zero, and supposed to disable that. So it shouldn't happen, but you'll never have a problem if you don't have wires crossed at the terminal. You could cut this end off and twist them together. This firing system is just going to see that as about an 8 amp or 6 amp load, probably. It's just going to see it as a load. It's right at the cue, was you know, really draw a lot of amperage.